Hello students, now we are going to see a problem based on the secant formula. Okay, let's see a question. So a column of circular section is subjected to a load of 120 kN. The load is parallel to the axis but eccentric by an amount of 2.5 mm. The external and internal diameter of columns are 60 mm and 50 mm respectively. If both the ends of the columns are hinged and column is 2.1 meter long, they determine the maximum stress in the column. Okay. So, the data given as, so what data we have? The load is P equals to 120 kN. It is a column of circular section. It is subjected to a 120 kN load. So this is 120 kN. Let us convert it into Newton, into 10 power 3 Newton. The load is parallel to the axis but eccentric by an amount of 2.5 mm. Okay, so we have seen here the load is eccentric. Okay, it is parallel to the column but it is eccentric and it is 2.5 mm. By an amount of 2.5 mm. Now the external and internal diameter of columns are 60 and 50 mm respectively. If both the ends of the columns are hinged. Now end condition is different here. End condition is it is both the ends are hinged. And column is 2.1 meter long. So in this case, eccentricity E is given as 2.5 mm. So it will be 2.5 into 10 power minus 3 meter. So units are very important and you should be careful what units we are considering. And diameter of the column is given as 60 mm and 50 mm respectively. That is external diameter is 60 millimeter. So it will be 0.06 meter. And internal diameter it is let it be small d. It is 50 mm. So 0.05 meter and length of the column is 2.1 meter. Now both the ends are hinged. Okay. So this is given for the effective length. So LE equals to L will be same 2.1 meter only. Now E is given as value of E is given as 200 giga Newton per meter square. Giga means 10 to the power 9 Newton per meter square. Okay. Now the maximum stress is given by maximum stress. Formula for the maximum stress is sigma max is equal to P by A plus P into E sec bracket LE by 2 into root of P by E I divided by Z. Now let us first we know the formula. Now let us find out what is the area. So area of cross section, that is we have external and internal diameter. So let us find out the area. Pi by 4 d square minus d square. 0.06 square minus 0.05 square. So we get this value as 8.639 into 10 power minus 4 meter square. Okay, this is the area value. Now similarly calculate moment of inertia, that is pi by 64 d raised to 4 minus d raised to 4 internal out external minus internal 5 by 4 0.06 power 4 minus 0.05 power 4. So I value we get it as 0.0329 into 10 power minus 5. Now we have I. So, what will be section modulus? I by y is section modulus. So I value we know 0. We have just calculated I value, that is 0.0329 into 10 power minus 5. And y is d by 2. Okay, y value is d by 2. That is the external diameter, 0.06 by 2. Okay, so when we substitute, we get section modulus as 1.0975 into 10 power minus 5 meter cube. Now we have calculated what is z, we have calculated what is a, we know what is I, we know what is e. Okay, these are all values we have now. Now let us see the whole part. How much is sec of le by 2? Sec of le by 2 root of p by ei. Effective length is same as actual length. Square root of p is 120 into 10 power minus 3 divided by 200 into 10 power 9 into I is 0.0329 into 10 power minus 5. So this gives us value as sec of 1.4179 radians. So this is in radians. Okay, now how to convert it into angle? So to convert it into angle, multiply it by 1.4179 into 180 by pi. So we get it as 81.239. Now sec of 81.239 is equal to 6.566. okay, so we have got this value as 6.566. now substitute all the values in this equation, so we get sigma max is equal to P is P by A first part, 8.639 into 10 power minus 4 plus 120 into 10 power 3 into 2.5 into 10 power minus 3 into 6.566 divided by 1.0975 into 10 power minus 5. So we get as 138.9 into 10 power 6 plus 179.48 into 10 power 6 Newton per meter square. So sigma max is equal to 318.38 into 10 power 6 Newton per meter square, or sigma max in millimeter we can write it as 318.38 Newton per millimeter square. Okay, so we are done with the solution of this problem. Okay, so you should remember what is the formula. Basically, once you know the formula, it's very easy to find out what is the area of cross section, moment of inertia, section modulus. When you get all the values, simply substitute here. And yes, at this stage, don't forget to convert this, okay? So radians to degree, and then once you add it, then we get the total angle over here, value of that angle, okay? So students, hope you have understood this problem, and thanks for watching. Thank you.